This cornerstone, this solid ground, firms through the fiercest droughts and storms.
Welcome to the Potter's House.
The Potter's House School provides a Christ-centered education to children of all ethnic heritages and income levels, equipping them to serve God and society to their fullest potential.
Hi, my name is Janelle Smith, and I am fifth grade.
My name is Jerry Rodriguez, and I'm in 11th.
And we'd like you to meet our principal. Mr. Blay is the superintendent of the Potter's House.
We like to talk with him, but
he's a little busy right now.
Every morning, each child is greeted at the front door
by name,
with a handshake,
and with a smile.
Let's go talk with Mrs. Haft instead.
Mrs. Haft is the principal of the elementary and middle school.
Mrs. Haft, what do you think makes the Potter's House so unique?
Well, I believe that the Potter's House is a community that truly embraces its mission statement by providing a Christ-centered education to children of all ethnic heritages and income levels.
Mr. Walcott, what do you think makes the Potter's House unique?
I think we have a wonderful blend of students from different cultures and ethnic backgrounds and with different gifts. And I think that makes our school an exciting place to learn and it makes us strong.
If you could describe the Potter's House High School in one word, what would it be?
Exciting.
Family.
I'm Ruth Rodriguez.
And I'm Chris Gordon.
And we'd like you to meet some very important people.
The students of the Potter's House. We have a question to ask you guys. Where do you see Jesus at the Potter's House? You. I saw your hand first. Everywhere. You.
Family worship.
Family worship.
What's your favorite thing about the first grade?
I'm Tiffany, and I'm in 12th grade. I see Jesus in all of the teachers because they're all Christian and they want to help you become stronger in your faith.
My name is Alyssa Smedding, and I'm in 12th grade.
I see Jesus in the teachers and how they're always willing to help us with not only schoolwork, but also what we're going through in life.
My name is Daniel Mahari, and I'm a junior.
Where do you see Jesus at the Potter's House?
On the sports teams. When the guys, you know, we have pregame devotions, you know, you really don't see that from any other team. When we go out there, We're going out there with passion. We're not playing for ourselves.
My name is Jackie and I'm in sixth grade.
I think I see Jesus during discipleship and through the teachers.
I'm Jasmine and I'm in kindergarten.
Rebecca,
kindergarten?
We're both at the same table.
Where do you guys see Jesus here at the Potter's House?
On the cross. Over there on the paper.
The white cross.
Hi, my name's Caitlin Chan, and I'm in fifth grade.
And I'm Joseph Tapanis, and I'm in 11th grade.
We'd like to introduce you to some very important people.
Teachers here at the Potter's House.
I'd like to introduce you to Miss Jones.
Mrs. Jones, how long have you been teaching at the Potter's House?
This is my first year, and I did my student teaching here last semester.
What's it like teaching at the Potter's House?
I love the diversity and the community, and just the sense that God is here and He's in everything that we do.
Mr. Cole, what do you like about teaching at the Potter's House?
Well, I like the small class size, and that gives us an opportunity to really listen to students, to pray with them, to talk with them, and try to help them where they are living at that point. Think of the word family. I think we strive towards sincerity, towards being genuine and real with the students and really trying to help them.
We'd like you to meet Mr. Van Zanten. He teaches 4th and 5th grade here at the Potter's House.
Mr. Van was here since the very beginning.
Mr. Van, what has changed at the Potter's House over the last 25 years?
I think everything has changed and nothing has changed. We moved from 19 kids that first year
to over 450 now. It's different in the fact that we can offer a lot more. We have computers, we have Spanish, we have band, a middle school sports program, we have a middle school wing now, early all wing. When we started 25 years ago, Nellene Dimster and I, Miss D, we would meet at 7:30 in the morning and have prayer and devotions before the school day. And here we are 25 years later, we still do that. We meet at 7:30 for prayer and devotion. So that's really a critical piece of who we are. We really wanted this to be a place where kids felt they belonged, that they had a place here. Through different intentional efforts, through middle school discipleship, through anchor worship, family worship, different programs, we are accommodating our kids and making them feel like they are valued, they belong, and encouraging to be built up. There's a little promo that we ran earlier today. It's future stars of the NFL. So I'd say we probably got four or five candidates. Not for the Lions, but any other team. Oregon team, when we take your team down here, we need to eliminate. Let's set up. Let's make sure we got a man covering. Defense, be ready here. 28-22 Hutton.
My name is Cranon Roman, and I'm a senior at the Potter's House.
And my name is Chris Vanderick, and I'm an eighth grader at the Potter's House.
We would like you to meet some very important people.
Parents. This is Mrs. Tron.
Why did you choose the Potter's House for your children?
Because it's a Christ-centered school, and the diversity of the school. And especially, I see the teacher teach my children with their passion. That the teacher actually pray for my children.
In the lives of my children, the Potter's House has made a phenomenal difference. It has given them great opportunities that takes them into college and beyond. And most importantly, it has given them a foundation that is built upon Christ.
If you had to describe the Potter's House in one word, what would that word be?
The Potter's House is love. It's a blessing.
I'm Kehlani Sanford, sixth grade.
I'm Matt DeYoung, and I'm in the 12th grade.
We'd like you to meet some very important people.
Our supporters.
This is Mr. and Mrs. Osterink.
They are friends of the Potter's House.
Mr. and Mrs. Osterink, what's your favorite thing about reading to these wonderful first graders?
Well, getting to know them. We don't just read, we spend some time where they get to tell me about themselves and about what's going on in their lives and their family.
What do you find to be unique about the Potter's House?
I think one of the really unique things is the story of how it started. It came without any human agenda, but just out of people moving into a neighborhood and loving their neighbors. And I just think it's so God-centered. The staff prays every morning to start their day, and haven't forgotten that the real source of strength here comes from God.
This is Mr. Senator Bill Hardiman and Mrs. Hardiman.
They are friends of the Potter's House.
Mr. and Mrs. Hardiman, why is the Potter's House important to you?
It provides great Christian education. And I think that's exemplified in one class. That's Mrs. Ritter's second and third grade class. They've adopted me as their leader over the past several years, and they're just wonderful. I go in and I'll talk to the class and meet with them and try to share a little bit about what I do. They pray for me, they send me cards. They're always there for me, and it's just wonderful to see them, whether that's here at the Potter's House or in Lansing. They're a wonderful influence in my life, and I think the whole school is a great influence in this community.
This is Mr. Peter Cook.
Of the Cook Foundation.
Why is the Potter's House important to you?
Well, I believe in young people. I think if any people are interested in the future of our city or our community, our neighborhood, or our country, they should know that Potter's House is one of the schools that train young people to be important in the future.
My question is, how did you come to know about the Potter's House?
Well, I was born in this neighborhood. I was raised in this neighborhood, born on Shamrock Street, which is down a few blocks, and raised on London Street, which is down a few blocks that way. And so, this is my neighborhood. This is how come I got to know Potter's House.
This is Mr. Dick DeVos.
He is a friend of the Potter's House.
Mr. DeVos, how is the Potter's House special to you?
Potter's House is special because I think of its diversity, and also because it's such an open and welcoming environment that maintains high academic standards and yet keeps its doors open to everyone. encourages faith, it encourages learning, and it requires high standards.
Explain the Potter's House in one word.
I would choose the word open. It's open to everyone that wants to come. It's open to great learning. It's open to great dialogue, and it opens doors for every one of the students to move forward and to be really a wonderful part of our community.
The superintendent of the Potter's House.
Finally, on Granville Avenue, met up with Mr. Boy. Mr. Boy, the Potter's House. Why here?
Long before you were born, way back when I was in college, around 1974, I was in a college fellowship group. So we began to pray that God would show us a neighborhood, and this is the neighborhood we felt drawn to. And so we moved in here in about 1975 and started to build relationships with our neighbors. A lot of children started coming to our houses, and before we knew it, we had more than 150 kids coming to our house every week for Bible studies, crafts, supper, and singing. As we got to know them over the next 6 years, we became overwhelmed with the needs that the children in this neighborhood had. What was going on in their homes, what was going on socially in the neighborhood, and academically. A lot of the students in this neighborhood were 2 to 3 years behind what they were at the other side of the same city in the same school system. At that time, Reverend Pontier from a local church challenged us with the words, "I think it's God's timing for you to start a school." We agreed with him. After praying about that, we thought a school is exactly what these students need to challenge them to be all that they can be. And that's why we started a school, based on the needs of the kids in this neighborhood.
Mr. Boy, what should people know about the Potter's House?
People should know that God is doing an amazing work at the Potter's House. We're all here because over the past 25 years, God has worked in the hearts of hundreds of people to volunteer time and support us financially so that our Potter's House school can exist. Because our mission is to provide Christ-centered education for families from all backgrounds, we really need to raise about $4,000 per child a year. And that's only possible because God has moved in the hearts of hundreds of people to partner with us to make this school a reality.
No power of hell, no scheme of man.
Abby, what is your name and what grade are you in it? That's all right. All right, take three.
Back
Thank you.
You.
And good night.
Back to you, Bob.